This came to light on today as the technical team from the ministry led by Ronald Segawa Jagenda, the Undersecretary and Commissioner in Charge of Finance and Administration, appeared before the Public Accounts Committee Central to respond to the Auditor General's queries for the financial year 2020-2021. Although the ministry had planned to collect non-tax revenue of 8.9 billion shillings, the committee learned that they were able to collect only 2.1 billion shillings due to invasion of desert locusts that invaded northeastern Uganda and disrupted agriculture activities on top of COVID-19.
Because we had to cordon off the places, and we're having an operation both in the air and on the ground. So these restrictions of movements affected the main routes which we use for the main products that go to Sudan, and these are mainly livestock-related products, milk, eggs, and livestock and beef itself. So our collectors of NTR are at the border posts, and they sell license from the border posts. So some of the routes to southern Sudan were affected by that operation.
It contradicts the previous response, because the previous response of the accounting officer on this non-tax revenue was, the accounting officer explained that underperformance was due to the economic activity in the sector, especially in the first two quarters. But also he goes to say the locust invasion also affected business activity in the eastern part of the country, and all these slowed agriculture business.
However, committee members were not at all persuaded by the impact of desert locusts on low collections of non-tax revenues.
The committee has powers to compare production of documents. So since the accounting officer has stated that those one was an issue, for us to be able to convince ourselves, as she says she's not convinced, even me, I'm not convinced. Wouldn't it be better for them to produce evidence, documents, to show that those border issues had an effect of locusts and brought the following problems?
Well, it's what we want to understand, because you see, when you look at the sources of NTR, the relationship between those sources and locust invasion is really virtually not there. So that's why we were not convinced and asked for explanation in writing.
In the same vein, the committee learned that the Minister of Agriculture, Animal Industry and Fisheries through the National Agriculture Research Organization, NARO, is in advanced stages of establishing a local vaccine manufacturing infrastructure at Nachesasa in Wakiso district to produce vaccines for ticks, foot and mouth disease.
Facility in Nachesasa has been set up. They want to produce now what you call the foundation strain, which can be multiplied. And but we first tracked the one of the tick, because the tick had become so serious at the time.
MPs criticized the government for spending more than 50 billion shillings to facilitate research and vaccine development without making any efforts to facilitate the Minister of Agriculture to respond to cattle-related diseases.
These diseases are not, they are not new. They talk about original research. And since we are the market, Uganda is the market, why can't they go to these other companies which did the research long ago, which have money, and they come and establish a manufacturing point here instead of spending money which they don't have and even buying? I want to know if they have tried that one.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.